will talk about spectrum, renormalization, and two-dimensional dynamical system associated with sort of subsimilar groups.
Thank you. Very grateful to the Institute of Mathematical Sciences, the Science Center for Geometry and Theoretical Physics for invitation. Very pleasant, very nice. And because the program now in IMS is on renormalization, I included this work in my talk. I will try to explain how it appears in group theory. I advertise four books, which more or less are, in fact, are relevant to the subject of my talk. The book by Hanon Bas and three co-authors of him, Cyclic Renormalizations. His book about the renormalization in when you model one-dimensional dynamics, as far as I understand, but there is chapter written by Hanon Bas on algebraic properties of the group of automorphism of root 3, like infinite binary root 3, for instance. So I started with advertising here. In 2000, this book was published, in any case, you see, from the title, we see groups and dynamical aspects. I was editor of this issue of the Rostislav of Mathematical Institute, Dynamical System Automaton Infinite Groups. It's 2000, where many papers are in the direction of my talk. And I advertise the book by Vladimir Nekrasevich, my colleague in Texas A&M University, which is now a kind of Bible on similar groups. The goal of the talk is to advertise the use of self-similar groups in dynamics and the spectral theory of graphs. And so I will, at some moment, I will define what are self-similar groups. And I have to emphasize now that there are many, many connections of this class of groups to various topics in dynamics. And most of them are not explored well enough. And here I will try to present just a beginning of a certain direction which only now started to accelerate. I will present some results and outline further research, and I will try to explain how renormalization appears associated with some similar groups and the spectral theory of graphs and groups. I was lucky in my life to meet many interesting and clever people. Among them, I met Sibony in Paris. Mr. Lyubich I know since he was a student. So at some moment I decided, okay, it's now to make propaganda of these subsimilar groups, basically groups invented by me in holomorphic dynamics. So I started to talk to Sibony, to Misha, to other people, and first observations were, you see, like this, not very encouraging. So these are the first two maps that in fact, are renormalization maps in certain problems, spectral problem. Okay, two-dimensional maps, like nothing special for the first moment with them. They come from some group, kind of mysterious group, very complicated, very nice, very beautiful, very interesting group, which I denote in this way, generated by four involutions, A, B, C, D, elements of order 2. I will call these maps F and G. F and G we will call first and second map. Basically, we will deal with first map. And group is interesting by the fact that it was it is group of intermediate growth between polynomial and exponential. And in 1984, answering the question of John Milnor from 1967. Gives a rough groups of intermediate growth. So this was the first example of the group of intermediate growth. In fact, group was constructed in 1980 as a group of Bernstein type. Finally, it generated infinite torsion. Later, I observed that it has intermediate growth. And both maps from previous slides are responsible for the same spectrum. By here, I mean a joint spectrum of certain pencil of operators associated with this group. And now second or next map B looks quite similar to previous. It comes from another famous, now very popular group called Basilica group, generated by this automaton of media type. Later I will explain how pictures like this generates a group. So far you just see that this is kind of oriented graph, the edges of which are labeled by pairs. And for instance, if you look at this pair 1, 0, one play a role of input, 0 play a role of output. And input tells us that if you are in node B, the next node will be A, end of error. But we'll come back to this later. Important fact is that Basilica is isomorphic to the so-called iterated monodromy group of polynomial z squared minus 1. And serves also as the first example of amenable but not as an exponentially amenable group. Previously, perhaps I forgot to say that additionally to the property have intermediate growth, the first group happened to be the first example of so-called amenable but not elementary amenable group, answering question of McLendane from 1957. So first example of non-elementary amenable group from the time when von Neumann in 1927 introduced the class of amenable groups. One more map, two-dimensional map. So what is special in this map? Many of you may immediately, so this map comes from the group which is called lamplighter group. It's so-called Vries product of a group of ordered two and infinite cyclic group. But this is nothing else. As you take direct sum of infinitely many copies of a group of ordered two indexed by integers. Now we consider shift automorphism of this Abelian group given by the shift along Z, adding one on the set of indexes. This is automorphism of the group. So you arrange a semi-direct product of this Abelian group with this generator of infinite cyclic group. You get this semi-direct product. This is the lamplighter. It's metabelian group. Metabelian group, extension of Abelian by Abelian of exponential groups, not finitely presented. Quite important in group theory group, but interesting fact is that also it can be defined by finite state automata shown here. And the generality of this map almost immediately is seen, because if you add these two fractions, you get x plus y after cancellation. So lines x plus y equal constant c are invariant with respect to this map. So really it is a very degenerate map. The Hanoi map, introduced in a paper by Zoran Sunik and me in 2007, more complicated. And I think Zoran gave a talk not far ago about Hanoi group, but maybe I will, certainly I will repeat something that he said in his talk. But as Sergei Novikov tells, to understand talk, one has to attend it 3 times. So you hear at least 2 times.
You need to tell us twice.
Okay, and now more about the first two maps. In fact, about the first map F. Remember the first slide, there were two maps F and G. So now I discuss the first map F. So if you consider map from C2 to C given by this formula, then it is a fact that it semi-conjugates the first map to the Chebyshev map, Chebyshev Ulam von Neyman map. And if you consider a family of hyperbolas parameterized by parameter theta given by this quadratic polynomial, then preimage of, I will call them horizontal hyperbolas, the preimage of such hyperbola is union of hyperbolas of the same type, where parameters theta 1, theta 2 are preimages of theta, of this parameter theta under the map alpha, Chebyshev map alpha. And for values of parameter theta in the interval minus 1, 1, the real, parts of these hyperboles fill the domain omega. And this figure shown. So these red lines are horizontal hyperboles, and they fill this tented area. So when parameter theta belongs to this. So basically, this picture is we start with concrete theta, say theta equal to zero, takes preimages, and draw pictures of this hyperbola. We get this interesting picture. Now, another map semi conjugates. F, first map, to the identity map. And so, vertical hyperbolas given by this equation parameterized by phi are just invariant. And now they are shown in the blue. And again, if phi arranges in interval minus 1, 1, these hyperbolas fill the same domain omega from previous slide. And what is red in one slide, blue in this, is in fact this is domain is represents the so-called joint spectrum of pencil operator associated with certain spectral problem, which will be explained later. Now, putting all together, now we consider the pair of these two maps, pi and psi from previous slide, we get a map pi from C2 to C2, which semi-conjugates first map F is identity cross Chebyshev polynomial. And because of this, one can deduce the theorem which during my talk at Misha's 16th birthday conference was called Little Lyubich G distribution theorem. Let gamma S be two irreducible algebraic to chaos in C2 in coordinates phi and psi, such that the gamma is not a vertical hyperbola, while S is not a horizontal hyperbola. Then we have this convergence. So we take preimage of gamma at the nth iteration of F, intersect with S, put delta mass at each point of the intersection, normalize to get probability measure, and weak topology, this converges to what is shown here. The MS is the restriction of this one form to curve S. So this is a starting point for a project, for the project initiated already maybe 6 years ago at the Saas-Fee ski resort in Switzerland by Misha and Speaker, now accompanied by Park Dunk. Dunk, so it's a mistake, but not really a mistake, because he told me that his father, spelling of his last name is Dunk. No? Okay, sorry, so should be clear. More on this at the end of the talk, on this project. Okay, now more impressive map. It's still associated with a group of intermediate growths, but now five parameters are involved. And another map, less impressive, but still looks quite complicated. So these are extended versions of the maps F and G that were at the first slide. And while those F is now well understood, well treated. We know very little about these two maps, but from some something related to the theory of random Schrodinger operator, and this is developed in my paper, this is Daniel Lenz and Tatiana Nanibida, we know that these maps are responsible for, again, for joint spectrum of certain pencil of operator, and this joint spectrum is presented by certain set omega tilde, which is an invariant with respect to these two extended maps. And this set, maybe it has kind of strange attractor or whatever, but we know that in most of direction, if we intersect this set by lines, we get a counter set of Lyubich measure zero, while there are some degenerate directions where sections are union of two integrals. Now, I will say a few words about graphs and what we mean by spectrum of a graph. So it's usually a graph is denoted by gamma. It consists of set of vertices V, set of edges E. And we have the following hierarchy. Locally finite graphs, subset graphs of bounded degree. By degree, we mean the degree number of edges adjacent to vertices, so uniformly bounded. Next class model is a regular graphs when the degree is fixed number, and this is kind of class of graphs which is more pleasant to work with, at least in spectral theory. And then vertex transitive graphs, graphs with big group of isometries, group of isometries X transitivity of the set vertices. And finally, subclass of Kelly graphs, I will recall what are Kelly graphs, but also inside class of regular graphs, there is another important class of graphs of algebraic origin, the so-called Schreier graphs, which also will be defined. And the fact is that there is no big difference between regular graphs and Schreier graphs, at least in the case of even degree. Every regular graph of even degree 2k, can be realized as a Schreier graph of a free group of k generator, of random k. So basically, regular graphs and Schreier graphs are the same. Okay, so what are k graphs? You have a group and system of generators S, and then you correspond a graph with a set of vertices, just elements of a group G, and the set of edges of this sort. Element of a group and another element obtained from previous by multiplication by generator. So this is left version of definition, left because we multiply on the left. Similar, there is a right form of definition, and for left definition, a multiplication on the right preserves the structure of Kelly graphs, so they are very highly transitive graphs. Now, Schreier graph. You have additionally subgroup H of group G, and given this data group, subgroup, and generating set A, S, we consider a set of vertices as a set of left cosets, and a set of edges as this pair. So, coset and coset obtained from previous by multiplication by generating. Kelly and Schreier graphs are D regular, where D is double cardinality of the generating set. And Kelly graphs are particular case of Schreier graphs. If you take H trivial subgroup, then you get Kelly graph. Here is an example related to this group of intermediate groups. So at the beginning, I started with a group generated by four convolutions, A, B, C, D. I didn't tell, but this group X by automorphism of infinite binary rooted tree shown here. So root is fixed points, and so group just permutes vertices of levels. And here are figure of Schreier graph. Another way to define Schreier graph is the following. If a group X on a set You take the set, this points of this set as vertices, and you join two vertices by edges, if one can be obtained from another by action of generator. And additionally, you can put label corresponding generator. Now, A, B, C, D actions are shown in the different colors. A, for instance, red, B, yellow, and so on. And here it's shown how the group acts on the first level, on the second level, on that level becomes pretty messy, and so on. There is no continuation of the picture, but in fact, if you analyze more carefully, you see, you can find that these graphs are not so complicated. They are isomorphic to graphs shown here. So kind of linear graphs. But if you look at, so here we use coding of vertices in standard way, like 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, and so on, lexicographic order. Now when you open these graphs, the labels of vertices look strange. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0 appears only here, so what was the left here is almost in the middle, and so on. And in fact, this is, so the graphs are simple without labeling, but with labeling of edges and with labeling of vertices, it's much more complicated. And there is a lot of hidden information in this picture. And in particular, there is a gray code is included in this data. And here is presented a Schreier graph of Hanoi group, group associated with Hanoi Tower's gain on three effects. This group acts on ternary rooted tree. And this is a figure of Schreier graph for that level. And again, if you look carefully what are labelings of vertices and labeling of edges, then, for instance, if you you know this game is you have a disk of different sizes and disk on one peg, and you have to move to another peg using the rule that a larger disk can be placed on the smaller. So solution is algebraically looks like ABC, ABC, and so on. You go from this vertex to this just stupidly making ABC steps and so on. But if you make, for instance, AC, 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 and so on, so it's, you go through all vertices all only once and so on. So there are many interesting phenomena. This is looking simply graphs and limited graphs is the Sierpinski gasket, our favorite object. Okay, now Markov operators. In the case, it's operator on the space A2 on graph, but by this we mean A2 on the set of vertices of the graph. So this is a different space that we will deal. And this is just operator of averaging. M applied to function f belonging to this space, evaluated at point x, is the following. You take the sum of values of function in vertices which are neighbor, and average, divide by d. We assume graph is a dear correct. So basically, spectrum by spectrum of a graph, we mean the spectrum of this Markov operator. Alternatively, we can consider identity operator minus Markov operator. This is a discrete Laplacian. And study of the spectrum of Laplacian basically is the same study of Markov operator. I prefer to work with Markov operators. They are related to random walks. On graphs, in our case, it's a random walk where you move in all directions with the same probability b equal 1 over d. So the first remarkable properties are that M is self-adjoint operator of normal greater than 1, so spectrum is subset of interval minus 1, 1. Graph is called amenable if 1 belongs to the spectrum, equivalent to normal operator is 1. The group is called amenable if the carrier graph is amenable. These are not original definitions, but in the spirit of my talk, I remind notion of amenability, because it will play some role later, and at the beginning I also mentioned amenability. And by spectrum of a group, in fact, we mean a spectrum of the marked group. A marked group is a group together with system of generator. And spectrum of such data is spectrum of the corresponding Kelly graph.
So the definition of the Lyubich group does not mention any generators. So is this independent of the choice of the generators?
No, no. It depends very much on the choice of
the
generators. So
the group is amenable if it's Kelly graph. It's actually equipped with a particular set of generators?
If group is amenable, norm is one. One is in spectrum for any system of generators. Yeah. But the spectrum can be for different generators, will be different in general. Yeah. And so when I say spectrum of a group, in fact, I mean spectrum of a group plus a certain set of generators. And I specify each time which generating set I mean. More general concept is weighted graphs. So you may put, in principle, arbitrary weight on edges. Previously, we associated with each edge one over d, the same number. But we can put different numbers and consider them corresponding weighted. Markov will be not exactly Markov, because weight can be take even a negative values. But for instance, if you have a set of generators S and symmetrize it, and put any probability distribution on this union, which is asymmetric, probability of generator is the same as probability of inverse, then you consider a corresponding Markov operator MP given by this formula. And this is a Markov operator corresponding to random walk in which transition probabilities along generators are basically prescribed probabilities. So it's real Markov operator, and when P is a uniform distribution, as we started with, this is called the isotropic case, and otherwise anisotropic case. But what are the basic questions about spectra of infinite graph? Yeah, so there is huge theory of spectra of finite graphs, many books. Such important directions as expanders, Ramanujan graphs. Infinite study of spectra of infinite graphs, it has a different specifics. Here are the basic question. What could be the shape of the spectrum of a regular graph or a group? Just we know that it is closed subset of interval minus 1, 1. What else? Can any closed subset be realized? Or at least up to homeomorphism? What types of spectrum appears? In particular, can it be a Cantor set or at least have infinitely many gaps? For instance, can a torsion-free group have a gap in the spectrum? So just not to be interval. Very hard question, because if yes, we get a counterexample to famous Carison-Kaplansky conjecture on interpotence in sister algebras. Additionally, we can define spectral measure. So using spectral theory, we can associate with Markov operator as a family of spectral projection. For every Borel subset of reals, we can associate this projection E of P. And then we can define measure U evaluated on P as this inner product. We take data function at identity element, apply projection, take scalar product with data function. We get measure, spectral measure. What can be said about this measure, in particular what is decomposition of this measure onto absolutely continuous singular and poor point part. Very little is known. about Riesler equation, and one can formulate many other interesting and important questions. So classically, study of lattices like Z to the power D is classical, and there are finite extensions like crystallographic groups. Print, this is very classical. Now, regular prints, like infinite regular prints. This is not a regular tree, infinite, like infinite regular tree, like Z, or for instance, like Kelly graph of a free group of two generators, also. This time, a four regular tree. This case was already studied by Kesten in 1959, who initiated the theory of random walks on groups. A lot of work was done by Italian school of mathematicians. So this is a case of a free group or perturbational free group, like free product of finite groups. Malazyumov-Tepliaev came from point of view of fractal theory, so they studied the graph of bounded degrees, showed that the contour spectrum can appear in the case of graphs of bounded degree. In my paper with Laurent Bartoli in 2000, we showed that the spectrum of Schreier graph can be a contour set or a union of a contour set and a countable set of isolated points accumulated to it. So, for regular graphs, at least we know that this type of two types of spectra may appear.
So what is the group in this area?
In this case, it's a Gupta-Sitki group and the Fabrikovsky Gupta group. Here, more references. In 2015, Nikolashev, Sunik, and I printed a survey on what is known in this direction. Now I will formulate a couple of results. So already in 2001, with Andrzej Żuk, we showed that the spectrum of Kelly graph could be a poor point spectrum. Namely, if you take a lamplighter group and a set of generators generators corresponding to those automatons that was shown on the figure, then the spectrum is poor point. It consists of eigenvalues of this form. Cosine pq, where pq are alpha prime numbers. And these eigenvalues densely pack interval minus 1, 1. So as I said, it's interval minus 1, 1, but it's poor point spectrum in the sense that eigenfunctions constitute a complete system in A2 on the group. And by the way, this result was used by Linel Schick-Zuckermi to answer one of the questions of ITI and to give a counterexample to the so-called strong ITI projection. And then we constructed remaining manifold of dimension 7 with non-integer A2 Petit number, which in our case was 1 over 3. And the question of ITI was if there are manifolds with non-integer A2 Petit numbers. And then maybe additionally, it's irrational. So it's irrational was just a couple years ago. Examples done. Now, recent result. So the lamplighter map, which appeared when I showed a slide with the lamplighter group, is involved in obtaining the previous and the next result. Now, we take parameter mu, say real parameter mu, and consider a linear combination of generators A inverse, B inverse of the lamplighter group, but plus we add element C of this form, it's involution. A and B elements of infinite order, but C is involution. And we put this coefficient mu, parameter mu, so we get one parametric family of elements of a group algebra of the lamplighter group. And then we consider the operator of convolution in A2 on the group. Operator of convolution with this element of a group algebra. So basically, this is the same as we consider Kelly graph of a lamplighter group with this generating set of free elements A, B, C, and we put equal weights to all generators, but to see we prescribed weight u, and then reason the result by Brian Simanek and me tells that for arbitrary value of mu, this operator has a poor point spectrum, and if absolute value of mu is not greater than 1, then this eigenvalue is a densely packed interval, shown here. While if absolute value of mu is greater than 1, then additionally to this eigenvalues that densely packed the interval, we also have a countable sequence of points that accumulate to a point outside the interval. So all these points are also outside interval and accumulate to a point outside interval. So as a corollary of this, we now know that spectrum Kelly graph can have infinitely many gaps. There was no results of this sort. So in this spectral theory, people are always increasing in number of gaps and so on. And moreover, the spectral measures that was defined in this case, okay, it's discrete, and we computed it completely, it's given by this expression, and here I involve zeros of certain orthogonal polynomials, and these orthogonal polynomials are presented through Chebyshev polynomials of the second kind. Okay. Now, the second result. Relates the question, can one hear the shape of a group? Mark Katz in 1966 asked in his article, asked a very famous question, can one hear the shape of a trunk? Thousands of papers maybe were written on this subject. Almost immediately, Milnor observed the existence of a pair of 16-dimensional tories that have the same eigenvalues but different shapes. However, the problem in dimension 2 remained open until 92, when these people constructed, based on Tsunada method, so some algebra was involved, a pair of regions in the plane that have different shapes by identical eigenvalues. The regions are concave polynomials. Two papers with the same title appeared, written by Valette and Fujiwara, famous names in group theory and around. And they ask, can one hear the shape of a group?
So when you say time, actually, you don't need concave, but they're not convex. They're polygons that are not convex, right? They are it doesn't really make sense to say it, but.
Maybe there was a picture, so what kind of polygons?
They're not convex. They're not convex.
Yeah,
so that's what you mean by concave, it's actually not convex, which is not standard terminology. Yeah,
compliment is.
Well, if the complement was, then it would be convex. If the complement was concave, then the...
Okay, I'm sorry. seven triangles, two domains created of seven triangles. Yeah. You just put glue them differently. Sorry, let me delete this concave. The regions are polygons. okay, so the answer to these questions of Valette and Fujiwara is no, and no in a very strong sense. And this is a result by our template code. So here, today, chair is Dmitry, and I hope to have articles with Dmitry, but right now I'll have only these out there. My group of intermediate groups that I studied with has a generalization to a continuum family of groups, labeled by infinite ternary sequence omega, so point of this space. And the generating set consists of A, B, C, D as before, but A is like standard automorphism of binary tree, while the definition of P, C, and D depends on omega. And all these groups have intermediate growths. They are quite different because they have different type of growths. But all of them have the same spectrum. So here we have uncountably many of quite different groups with the same spectrum. So really, answer is a no.
Propose spectral measures.
We are not able to compute spectral measures. And there will be comment concerning spectral measures very soon. And moreover, if we fix omega, then we have just a single group with such spectrum, but then we can cover this group by uncountably many amenable groups, again generated by four involutions, and still the spectrum of each of this current group will be the same. So, like kind of double, double answer no. And now we work with Tatiana Nimida, her student, I taught Paris, and, to generalize this result in various directions. So this attempt to present a picture of Kerry graph of the first group of intermediate growths. It's very difficult usually to draw pictures of Kerry graphs if the groups are non-commutative. So spectrum of this graph is a union of two intervals, minus shown here. This plus this. One belongs to spectrum because intermediate growth automatically implies group is amenable. It should be. Yeah. Okay. The proof uses the Kolonitsky theorem, famous Kolonitsky theorem on characterization of amenable groups in terms of the weak containment of trivial representation into regular representation. And with Dutko, we created what we call big Kolonitsky type theorem for covering graphs. But this theorem, what I stated, is for isotropic case, when the probabilities of generators are the same, 1 over 4. In anisotropic case, we don't know what is the spectrum. Let me skip. So, as corollary, we get that there are uncountably many groups with pairwise, not quasi isometric Kerry graphs, but with the same spectrum. So we cannot distinguish not only up to isometry using spectrum, but even up to much bigger equivalence relation, quasi-isometry. Kerry graphs are not quasi-isometric because groups have different rates of growth, and the rate of growth is quasi-isometry in there. Now, spectral measure. Now I formulate. That's a spectral measure. In fact, during my talk in Geneva, Pelissard, famous mathematician and theoretical physicist, he suggested that the right question is, does the spectral measure mu determine Kerry graph up to isometry? And the remark is that it could be true because spectral measure not only determines spectrum, but determines, for instance, probability of return to identity elements, so-called Ahara zeta function, and some other important characteristic of the graph. So right now there is no any example showing that the spectral measure doesn't determine Kerry graph up to isometry. So similar groups. Given in vertical we need automaton A with the input and output alphabet X and the set of states Q, one defines a group generated by this automaton. In fact, this group generated by initial automata. So automaton is non-initial, but if you prescribe state as initial Q, then we get initial automaton, and they use different states for the generation of a group.
Maybe you say a few words how automata generate groups.
Just 10 seconds, please. Such group automatically act on D-regular rooted trees. D is the cardinality of the alphabet. They also act on the boundary of a tree. So for binary rooted tree, boundary naturally can be identified with the space of infinite binary sequences. Geometrically, it's just infinite paths joining the root with infinity. So here is a nicer picture. The set of states of automaton is a generating set of a group, as I told. And now a definition by example. By example, here we have free state automaton. Alphabet is a 0, 1. And So we can create from this initial automata free and non-initial, free initial automata, declaring this state initial, this or that. That state corresponds to identity element. So given such a picture, and if you specify which state, for instance, let us think that A is initial state, then for every n, we get a map from binary strings of length n to itself. Now I explain how this acts. So for instance, initial state is A, input string is this one. This is our automaton, red shows that this is initial state. We are looking for each, each edge is labeled by pair of symbols. We are looking those edge which starts at this state, and the left label is zero, this one. Then output will be one, input was zero, output will be one, and next state will be B. So now at next moment we are in state B, and we are looking for next input symbol, which is zero. We find H on the left labeled by zero, this one. And we see that next state will be A, while output will be zero. And so step by step, we change position of the automata, state of automata, and produce output symbol. So the length of output will be the same as length of input. This is the way how automaton operates on strings, and this action gives you action on the set of vertices of the tree, and it preserves the structure of the tree. So for each state of automaton gives you automorphism of the tree, and the composition of such automorphism can be again described by automaton. And this is how we, so we use all three states of automaton to generate a group. But if you are in this state, we will never leave it, and for input 0, output 0, input 1, output 1, so it's identity and trivial automorphism. Okay, so as I told, the automaton group, also similar group, is a group generated by state of the automaton. And examples of this odometric classical can be generated in this way. Infinite Hegel group, a group of intermediate growths, Basilica, Hanoi, created monodynamic group of Z squared plus I, many other important groups can be generated in this way. Now, random Schreier graphs. So, group acting on a rooted tree acts also on the boundary of the tree. And so, if we denote Vn, the nth level of the tree, and by gamma n, the graph of action of group on nth level, as was shown on the figure, colored figure. So, we get sequence gamma n of graphs for each level. And for the same, we can take point of the boundary x, take orbit, and build a graph with a set of vertices on this orbit, graph of action. We get gamma x, so we get uncountable family of graphs where x is point of the boundary. Okay. We can view this family as a random graph if we put a uniform Bernoulli measure on the boundary, which is invariant with respect to the full group of automorphism of the tree. And these infinite graphs, they are natural limits of finite graphs. So infinite graphs are natural limits of finite graphs, and therefore we can study a spectrum of infinite graphs, approximating them by finite graphs. Now we can define the density of states. So if Mn is a Markov operator on gamma n, we can consider counting or cumulating measure mu n on this graph. So we put just delta mass 1 at each point of the eigenvalue of Markov operator n average. So we get a probability measure. And then we know that the spectrum, so this is the result, all the results by Bartoletti and me, But there is a recent generalized version by Dotko and me. It tells that the spectrum of this graph, kind of graph, doesn't depend on the point of the boundary. And moreover, in amenable case, when these graphs are amenable, gamma x, the spectrum sigma is just closure of the union of the spectra of finite graphs. And moreover, there is a limit of this counted measures mu n, which I denote mu star, and called the density of states. At the beginning, we call them a KNS spectral measure. So mu is an analog of density of states for the random Schrödinger operator. And in fact, there are more relations with the field of random Schrödinger operator observed by Barry Simon, Grabowski and Vera. Lens, Magnifida, Simanek. So now I'm going to explain how renormalization appears in the spectral problems that we discuss. Assume H is Hilbert space and decompose a direct sum of two subspaces. And M is a bounded operator in H. And we present it as a 2x2 matrix according to this decomposition. So A, B, C, D are itself operators in corresponding spaces. Assume D is invertible, then the first sure complement denoted in this way is this expression. Similarly, if A is invertible, you can define second sure complement. And it's classical fact from 19th century, perhaps, that M is invertible if, suppose D is invertible, then M is invertible if and only if the first sure complement is invertible, and similar for the second one. And inverse is given by this expression. So sure complements are useful to invert. Matrices to invert operators. And similarly, one can define sure maps as I when you you decompose Hilbert space as direct sum of D subspaces. So here I'm for decomposition as direct sum of D summons. Assume the dimension of Hilbert space is infinity. And then H is isomorphic to direct sum of D copies of A itself for any D greater or equal to. All separable Hilbert spaces are isomorphic. I assume it's separable Hilbert space. And so, okay, we can fix isomorphism. And any such isomorphism I call dissimilarity. And these dissimilarities are in bijection with the star representation of the Kuhn's sister algebra, famous, usually denoted OD. Now, if M of Z, Z is an element of space C to the power k, is an operator valued function with values in bounded operator on certain Hilbert space, infinite dimensional Hilbert space H, then we can say that joint spectrum of this function is a set of those values of Z for which operator is not invertible. So let us call this joint spectrum. And assume that we are in a situation that there is a dissimilarity and a map F from C to the power k to itself such that for some index I, the sure complement applied to operator M of Z is operator M but evaluated at point F of Z, where F is this map. In this case, the spectral problem to find joint spectrum usually reduces to the finding of suitable F invariant subset omega and C to the power K. And this map now is a renormalization map associated with a given spectral problem. The above approach is applicable in many cases related to self-similar groups and the Schreier graph, and in all tested cases, F is a rational map. And if these two and F is semi-conjugated to one-dimensional map, as we started with the first map, then J spectrum can be described completely. I'm almost done, but let me finish this example. So let's H be Hanoi Tower groups. That because of self-similarity, we know that the operators in this spectral problem, spectra of the Schreier graph presented in one of the figures that appear at the beginning. If we go to hyperspace, infinite dimensional hyperspace, then we get recursions of this sort. So A now is not a generator of a group, but corresponding operator in corresponding hyperspace. So operator A is presented by matrix of, with value zero identity operator O again, operator is the same sort, okay, so similar operators. And basically we are interested to take the sum of these operators and determine what is the spectrum. But if we add these matrices, so you will get, have A here, B here, C here, and once otherwise. Instead, once we put Y. And minus X identity is a, like in spectral problem, operator minus X identity operator. So we get this operator valid matrix. But then we again apply recursions, enlarging our matrix to size 9 by 9. And then we permute rows and columns. This doesn't affect invertibility. And we apply short complement to the first corner. And we get that short complement applied to this pencil of matrix operators is the same operator the same time, but for the values of parameters, change now x prime y prime given by this rational expression. So this is a renormalization map in a current problem, spectral problem, and this map is semi-conjugated to one-dimensional map given by this quadratic polynomial via map psi. And the spectral problem that we are interested in gives the following solution. It's a closure of the union of hyperbolas h theta given by this equation. Theta is parameter, where theta takes value. We start with a set of 2 points, 0 and minus 2, and we take pre-images under this one-dimensional map. So we get a bunch of hyperboles, we take union of them, plus we attach these lines, and we take closure of this, and this gives us a joint spectrum for certain pencil of operator from which we can deduce what is the spectrum of the Schreier graph, infinite Schreier graph associated with Hanoi Tower's group. And this is a geometric picture of this joint spectrum. This is the union of these hyperboles plus these lines. And now the spectrum of a Markov operator, to obtain you just cross this joint spectrum by vertical or horizontal line, I forgot. And you get in a section the spectrum of the operator, of Markov operator on corresponding Schreier graph. And in a given case, it's a countable set of isolated points which accumulate to a counter set. So as I said, geometrically, spectrum is counter set plus countable set of isolated points. But in fact, it's square point spectrum in this case as well. And final, as I promised, slide is brief description of the Saas-Fee project by Bob Dunk, now correctly written, Misha Lyubich, and me. And here is a short description. And thank you for your attention.
Questions?
So, in your examples with Bartholdi, when you have this counter. Is that due to the renormalization transformation?
Yes.
How many dimensions?
two dimensional. But it's quite complicated, but can be written on this blackboard. No, in fact, it is not so tremendously complicated, but certainly more complicated than the examples that we are considering here. But the same phenomenon is semi-conjugated to one-dimensional, and spectrum is union of higher particles.
I see. So it is also an integrable case?
Yes.
I wonder, is there a class of groups where the spectrum does determine the group? So any chance for some nice class?
Trivial group. Basically no. But you see, you can is where Dedekind and Frobenius, who basically are like associated with each element of a group, weight. So for each element of a group, you have variable which like represents weight. And now, if you consider determinant of this of Laplacian of adjacency matrix, then this determinant determines the group. But these many variables are involved, and decomposition in irreducible components corresponds to decomposition of group into regular representation into irreducible representation. This works for finite groups.
Okay, we will go for dinner around 6, well, by 6 to Lusa. So just tell me if you would like to join. Thank you.